I'm going to talk about the Gargano fauna, or southern southeastern Italy. Okay. As you maybe know, it is an insular fauna, very rich fauna, with a lot of very endemized.
Take some distance from okay. The otherwise it will distort.
Okay. Very endemized taxa, like the giant insectivore Deinogalerix, giant birds of prey, the very enigmatic ruminant-like taxon, the Opicomerix, and a lot of small mammals that became giant in proportions. Here we have the famous Microtia, which was used to arrange the deposits in a chronological order. And the deposits, as you can see, are the fissure fillings in a calcified carbonate platform. And they are sealed by marine deposits of dated to the lower Pliocene. Okay, and there are still some open questions about the origin of this fauna, and I have here some of the questions. One would be, which is the maximum age of the fauna? We know that the fauna cannot be younger than lower Pliocene, but we don't know the maximum age. Another question is, where did the ancestor of the elements of the fauna arrive? If they arrived from an eastern domain, or maybe from a western one? And another question, which is very dear to me, is that if the ancestors of the fauna entered the insular domain, in one single time window, or maybe in several time windows that were well, very well distinct in time. Okay, and without further ado, here are some novelties from the Fisher and Otter team, which was discovered by the University of Torino in 2009, and that is the small mammal assemblage. We had the opportunity to study the small mammal assemblage, and we soon realized that it is the oldest fissure ever retrieved in Gargano, and it has the primitive glids, Stertomys, and also two new taxa, a new murid, and a new chrysidid. And so I will talk first about the new chrysidid. I will not annoy you with the morphological details, but it is a very endemized chrysidid, very giant, it has giant proportions, and a very modified morphology with bulged cusps and crests. And the material is very scarce, we have only 5 teeth, but we tried to identify a possible continental ancestor for this chrysidid, and we did exclude 3 large group of chrysidid from the ancestry of this new endemic chrysidid. The first group is the Cricetodontini younger than MM9, because they have these ectoloffs, which are not developed in our chrysidid. Another group is that the Cricetini group, younger than MM9, because they have a very regular pattern with 6 cusps in the first upper and lower molar. And we also excluded from the ancestry of these chrysidid the oligocene chrysidids that have a very different morphology with transversal crests and additional connections between the cusps. And so we realized that maybe the ancestor is a yet unknown species of chrysidid, maybe from the early Miocene or middle Miocene, a chrysidid that can have a basic pattern similar to Democricetodon or maybe to Cricetodon. And this is very interesting because if this hypothesis is correct, then the ancestor would be sought among the time span of MM1, MM9, which is a time span that is not suitable for the dispersal of the murids, of Gargano murids, because I will show you that they have an MM13 affinity. And so this old, this old Chrysippid, a Chrysippid with an old affinity, to us is a strong proof of a colonization in different time intervals. Okay, the ancestor of the Chrysippid entered maybe in the middle Miocene, while the ancestor of the Murids entered during the Messinian, maybe. Okay. This is the new genus of Murid. It is the direct ancestor of Microtia. Maybe we can call this the oldest Microtia species, but it is a bit difficult because it has some features that are in common with Microtia, like the equidistant tubercles in the labial side of the upper M1, but also some characters that are very continental-like, like the anterior part of the first lower molar. And we realized that Microtia, this form is not related with Apodemus nor Stephanomis because of a lot of differences in the morphology. Maybe the most likely relative of this murid is the genus Hans de Bruyne. We are still working on it, but we think that maybe it's the most likely solution. And Hans de Bruyne is not known before MM1213, and it is also known in localities that are eastern respect to Bergamo, and so that would mean that the ancestor would have been entered the domain in MM1213 and from an eastern domain. And then I also studied the so-called Gargano Apodemus, which was known since the beginning, since the 70s of the last century, and it is not an Apodemus. It was never studied in detail. It was believed to be an Apodemus because of the occurrence of tubercle T7 in the upper molars. But I studied the finer details in the morphology, and me and my colleagues realized that it's difficult to consider this murid as an Apodemus because it has a combination of primitive and derived features. The T7 is a derived feature, but there are also some primitive features in these molars, which are, for example, the elongated tubercle T1 and the low crown of the teeth and the presence of tubercle T1 bis. Okay, and also we studied the youngest population of Apodemus from the youngest fissure that is called F32, and you can see that it becomes quite endemized, larger size with tubercles that are separated and very thick enamel. And so we called this taxon Apodemus, okay? And who is the ancestor of this taxon? We don't know, because some of these features are shared with the Micronis species, Apodemus species, or even Parapodemus species. So we don't know who can be the ancestor. But the frequency of T7 and some of the morphological features of this taxon suggest that the ancestor is an MM13 Murine species, maybe from an eastern domain. Okay. And then, last but not least, we studied the Deinogalerics from Scontrone. Scontrone is a locality near Gargano, 100 kilometers west of Gargano, and it shares with the localities of Gargano the macro vertebrates like Oplitonerics and Deinogalerics. And at the beginning, it was thought that this Deinogalerics was the small Deinogalerics frodentali from the Gargano fissures. But then we realized that even if the material is scarce, that at Scontrone we had two different species of Deinogalerics, one which is small and one which is larger. And these two species are characterized by peculiar proportions of lower P3 and P4, as you can see here. These are the length of P4 versus length of P3. These are the Gargano Deinogalerics, and these are the Scontrone Deinogalerics. And so we think that maybe these deinogalerics are part of a different stock. And the conclusions, a bit of a recap. The Fisher MO13 is the oldest ever retrieved in Gargano because it contains the primitive glials and the direct ancestor of Microtia. The ancestor of Microtia is maybe related with Hans de Bruyne, and so it would mean that it would be entered the domain in MM1213 from an eastern domain. The giant Chrysetid is a bit older in its affinity, so maybe its ancestor is entered in the domain in the middle Miocene or early Miocene. And then we have the former Apodemus, now Apatodemus, which is also a bit of a mystery, but suggests an ancestor of MM13 in age. And then we have the Scontrone Deinogalerics, which shows us a history of this island domain, which is more complex than what we talked before. And thank you.